Cool. Hey, good morning, everyone. How are we all doing? Good to see everyone. Kate up the back, nice to see you. It's officially our first meeting together in the building, 2022. Who's excited for this year? I am excited. Pressing in, pushing in, praying in, just believing for new things, new days, new seasons, and fully open to what God can do in all our situations and in our lives. And yeah, it's amazing to meet and to be in His presence, and just great to see everyone doing well and in health, having had a good Christmas and New Year. We're going to kick this year off with some worship, and the band are going to lead us, and then Alan Kelly is sharing today's word. So we've got a super exciting morning ahead. I hope we're all ready, fired up and filled up and ready to go. Why don't we stand and just welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit. You know, I was reading in Revelation about the throne of God and how the angels sing holy, 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 and all His beauty and His power and His might and His glory, and think that's the God that I'm worshiping this morning. That's the God that I have the privilege of stretching my hands out to in faith and believing that He can do amazing things, and He deserves my full, wholehearted worship this morning. He is worthy of all praise, and I want to encourage us this morning to kickstart 2022 with a heart full of praise and worship. Praise is our weapon. Praise is what we use in our battle against all the struggles that we face, and to praise God and know that He's going to move powerfully and mightily and gracefully in our situation. So I encourage us this morning, these guys are not leading worship, you're leading worship this morning. Let's give God all our praise, all our thanks, all our appreciation, and let's just lift His name high. Let's take the roof building off. Let's sing regardless of how you feel your vocals sound. Let's give God all praise and all glory. And as you worship Him this morning, think about that throne. Think about those angels who cover their face from His glory. Think about all these magnificent and wonderful things of heaven, the eternity, and all the supernatural things that take place around us, that we serve a powerful and mighty God. So when we worship this morning, let's show these guys up, and we'll show them who's the worship leaders this morning. Let's just open with a prayer. Father, we thank You so much that You're with us this morning, Lord God. We pray that You'll bless this service, Lord. We pray that You'll bless Alan's words this morning, Lord God. We pray that You'd be here with us, Lord. Where two or three are gathered, Father, we believe that this morning, that You're with us, that You're cheering us on, Lord God. You're supporting us, You're holding us up, You're strengthening us. Lord, we bless Your holy name, and we pray and thank You, Jesus, for all that You've done in our lives, Lord God, and all the great things that lie ahead for 2022, Lord God. You are in control. You are in control, Father. You sit at the right-hand side of God, Jesus, and we bless You and praise You and thank You, Jesus, for giving up Your life for us to be saved so that we can stand in Your presence this morning. Father, we give You all our praise and glory this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Are we ready to worship? 2022, the first time we've met. Let's just go for it and give it everything we've got. George, no pressure.
Thanks, Stephen, for a great word there, and I just wanted to share that Tim called me just last week, and he says that there's so much negative energy going about these days, and he says, let's sing songs of victory, and I think that's absolutely right. And we've got a song, Lindsay sent me this new song. We're going to start off the new year with this new song, and the chorus, it speaks about Your name is power, the name of Jesus, Your name is healing, the name of Jesus, and Your name is life.
Come on.
So let's praise like never before.
Mm. of Jesus over every heart and every mind. I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
I speak Jesus.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your
Yo. Seated on death couldn't hold you down. We're gonna lift our voice in victory. We're gonna make your praises loud. The enemy's been defeated, and death couldn't hold you down.
Thank you. every hard thing must come down. Every stronghold shall be broken.
Relationships, over our work, over our place, over this church, Lord. We declare all throughout the year as we start 2022, Lord, we seek to worship you and declare you are God, bigger than anything else. Hallelujah.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty,
let all the every choice, all the every choice. He wraps himself in the light, and darkness tries to hide, to tremble at his voice, and tremble at his voice.
You're the name above.
Amen. Let's give it up for Jesus. A massive round of applause. How good was worship? How fresh and how raw and how passionate and man alive is the presence of God not here with us this morning? It's incredible that God moves powerfully in worship. And I want to encourage us this year to be confident and to be positive and to be hopeful for the great things that lie ahead. I heard this amazing quote yesterday that said that it's not time that makes a difference. It's not the calendar changing from 21 to 22 that makes changes. It's how we see things and grasp things in our mind. And the Bible is full of encouragement and having a sound mind and great faith. And you think about all the miracles that took place in the Bible, the battles that were won, the Israelites being freed from Egypt, David beating Goliath, the walls of Jericho falling. The list of God's miracles and powerful moves are endless. And I really believe 2022, a year of praise and thanksgiving, is going to see tremendous things happening in our church and in our lives, our families, and in our nation. And we know that God's in control, yeah? Come on, He is in control. Almighty Father, Lord, we bless You and thank You. We know that You have great things ahead. You desire for us to succeed, Lord, to be blessed, to prosper. You desire our hearts to be fully committed and sold out for You, Jesus. And I pray that that would be our offering to You in 2022, Father, that we would give our hearts fully to You, Father. No distractions and nothing to come between us, but a heart that is burning for You, Lord Jesus. We pray Your Holy Spirit would fill each one of us up. I pray Your Holy Spirit would fill this room just now. Father, I pray You would fill the hearts of every person right now, Lord God. I pray You would lift heavy burdens, anxiety and worries, Lord God. We lay them down at the cross. We lay them down at Your feet, Lord God. You said You would lift the burdens, Father. And we pray this morning that we would hand over our burdens and we would start afresh with You, Father God, filled with Your Spirit. Without Your Spirit, Lord God, we have nothing. We are rusty and we run on human strength. And I pray this morning, Lord God, we'd be a people who learn to lean back on You, Father, that our hearts would burn ablaze, Your Spirit would fill us up, Lord God. If we've been distant, You're a God of grace and compassion and mercy, and Your arms are stretched wide open right now for anyone who feels distant, that You're desperate for Your children to be close to You. And I pray this morning that our hearts would turn, our hearts would be on fire, Lord God, our focus would be You. That song that we sang at the start, Jesus over everything. We pray this in Your holy name, Father. And we thank You that Your Spirit is here, that You're here with us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. How amazing did these guys do this morning? I think they deserve a massive round of applause, even more so because the reason it's 12 degrees in here is Tim forgot to put the heating on. I'm only kidding. He just said we'll get everyone dancing this morning. We'll not turn it on and we'll get people moving. So only kidding. It's warming up, guys. We're all good. It's so good to see you all. If you're visiting, a massive warm welcome to the Vine Church. We have people online and we have a fairly busy building, don't we? That's amazing to see. Well done, everyone, for coming along and pressing in. I'm going to highlight somebody this morning. I don't mean to embarrass them, but I do think we need to give them a warm welcome. She comes along to our youth group. She's an amazing girl, and she started to come to some of our Sunday services. And I think it would be a lovely gesture just to make her feel part of the family and to welcome her and say hello to her. So I'm going to highlight her. Her name is Kate. She's up the back. She's an amazing girl. And before you're in a situation, she's a taekwondo expert. So be careful how you approach her. Don't tap her on the shoulder from the back, or you never know. You might find yourself flipped on the floor or something. But Kate's amazing, doing really well. She's an absolute gem to have at youth on a Friday. And her favorite Christmas present this year was she got a toy, a dancing statue of Jesus for her car. I mean, What more can you have? The presence of Jesus in your car, dancing as you drive. What a great, great Christmas present to get, man alive. So, Kate, it's lovely to have you. You're such a blessing to us, and it's great to see you. So, massive warm welcome to you, Kate. So, yeah, moving back in, prayer meetings kicking off again. Stuart and Jill, massive thanks to you guys for running that. That's going to be back on this Tuesday, the 11th, and it runs from 9 p.m. to 9:30. So everyone's welcome. Details, I guess, will be on Facebook. I'm a anti-social media person, whatever the word is. I'm not on it anymore. But yes, social media will have all the details, or you could speak to Stuart and Jill, and they'll give you them as well. So prayer meeting, encourage everyone, if possible, to make it a family who prays together, stays together. I heard somebody say one time, and we are a family, it's great to meet and just to strengthen each other and cover each other in prayer. So Tuesday night, 11th, 9 to 9:30, and then that's Tuesday's running from then. Is Mel here? She is. I thought she might not have come because Tim didn't put the heating on, but she's turned up, so that's all good. Mel's going to give us a wee update on her Revive Cafe. Give me a second.
Good morning, everybody. Erin asked me just to share a little bit this morning, just quickly, about Revive Cafe, because some of you will know about it, maybe some of you don't know about it. I'll go back six, seven months ago. Rachel and I, who run a company called Embracing Life, who we do coaching, mentoring, that kind of thing. Our heart was burning for the community, and we really wanted to open up and give, you know, our best for the community, and be able to have a place for people to come, talk, and be listened to. So important to be listened to, and really be able to, have a place for that. And Erin and the team here kindly said we could use the cafe, which was lovely. So we opened the cafe. Always good to start with coffee. And that is what our main aim was, to serve good coffee. So we do. We open on a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and we have a full range of coffees and teas. We're doing a homemade soup, tray bakes, and yummy other things. We started baked potatoes and stuff as well. So we've been seeing amazing results, thanks to the prayers of you guys. And just amazing people coming in and, sitting, chatting. From all walks of life. We've had them from across the road in Tuke, Garvick, sometimes as far as Lochgelly, Blingary, coming along and just enjoying the chat, you know, safely. We've got a beautiful building, thanks to you guys for sewing into that. And we can safely have a coffee, have a bit of lunch, and that's been great. We also got big lottery funding, which was amazing. And we were really praying for that, because obviously we weren't making a lot of money to support us as a job in the cafe. So the big lottery kindly funded us at the middle of November to run activities for people to come in and just, you know, to reduce isolation, to reduce that feeling that they're kind of stuck in their house, or they maybe didn't have close family or people around them that they could come to and chat. So we started some activities. We've been doing lots of stuff. I love crafty things, so I was in my element. We were doing festive stuff before Christmas, making candles and wreaths and all sorts of things. So we're going to continue with that. The project runs until the end of, I think it's June. Yeah, end of June. So we're going to be doing, this month we're going to be doing self-care January. So we're going to be making bath scrubs, lip balms and stuff like that. So if you fancy, if you're, you know, at a loose end on a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, please do come along and, you know, meet with the people that are coming in. They're just fantastic. We've met some beautiful, beautiful people in our community, and it's just a great blessing to be able to meet with them and do these things. So there's lots going on. Probably I don't want to take up too much time, but please do. I really appreciate your prayers and really appreciate all the support that we've had with it. But yeah, we'd love to see you. Please do come along and see us. Thank you.
Stay there, Mel. You can stay there.
Stay there.
Yeah. Aaron's asked if we can pray. Is that all right? Because I know Mel is very positive and upbeat, but I know at the start you found it challenging and you've done amazing to get it to where it's at this right now. So we want to pray God's blessing and favour on it, and you guys could support that. Tim and Mel, you guys are tremendous people. I think the church just love you guys and all that you do, and the community is now being touched and blessed by what you do. So thank you to you both. Tim, you're in for a treat with all the bath bombs. I think any left over, you'll be like soaking it up. And oh, you've not got a bath. I'll just pass them on. We'll take them, Tim. Father, we thank you for Tim and Mel, and we thank you for their hearts, and we thank you for Mel and her team, Lord God, as they look to bless the community, Father. They look to be your hands and your feet, Father, and they look to sow seeds into lives, Lord God. And we just pray that you would go before them, Lord, that you would move and meet the needs of Mel and the team, Lord God, and you would meet the needs of those who come and have faced struggles, Lord God. We pray that the Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday that they meet, Father, that the room would be filled with your aroma and your presence, Father God. And we know that that radiates from Mel and the team, Lord God. And we just pray your Holy Spirit would be all over the cafe, Lord God. It would be all over the conversations and the topics that they talk about and the things that they do together. And we just pray your Holy Spirit would touch it and take it to a place that Mel and the team could not even begin to imagine, Father God. And we pray for great things to come, and we pray for your blessing upon it. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thanks, Mel. Awesome. Brilliant. Coffees are good too. Better than Tim's machine out there, but I didn't say that out loud. last announcement. Right now, media is something that we have available in our church, and we're very blessed in our nation, aren't we? We've got Bibles at the ready, we've got them in our homes, probably in different versions. We've got access to our mobile phones and tablets and internet, and there's many Christians out there that don't have those benefits. They meet in secret, they meet underground, and they're really difficult situations, but their hearts still burn for Jesus. And we've got this privilege in this country to have so many access to so many different things, and one of those things is right now media. I don't know if you've been on it, but it is tremendous. It's got so much content and things available for us, specific topics if you're struggling with things or want to learn more and do studies. It's all available, some incredible videos, easily explained, and it's available for free to you because you're just lovely people and you're Vine Church members, and we have that available. You can sign up in the foyer with Colleen. All you need to do is give your email address, but there's so much stuff. I really do recommend, what a great time to sign up, start off the year, 12 months ahead, to really use that to our advantage and strength, and to just for each of us to grow in our faith and build our knowledge and understanding in the ways of God and his heart for us. So that is available to you guys. Colleen is in the office, she'll be in the foyer, and you can sign up to that. And we really encourage you to do that. It's an amazing thing, and so grateful. Thank you to Aaron for making that available to us and putting it out there and really encouraging us. So, Right Now Media, have a look, check it out. You won't be disappointed. I'm sure you'll really enjoy it. We're going to show a promotional video, just in case I haven't sold it to you. I'm like, we're going to show it anyway, just to show you what is actually available through it. So if Kate is ready, that'll be great to go.
Welcome to our study of the Gospel of John.
I have fallen in love with the work of Paul as I've studied the book of 1 Corinthians, and I believe you will too.
This is where Jesus taught in Capernaum, and you have to understand this scene.
The Lord is my shepherd. And over the next 6 weeks, we're going to look deeply into the 23rd Psalm.
Right Now Media. It's for groups. It's for personal devotion. It's for parents.
The bullseye of parenting is to raise children who become like Jesus.
It's for kids.
This is Phil. We're digging into the Bible, which, as we've mentioned, is more than just a book.
It's for tough times.
So when you recognize that you're trying to have a conversation with your spouse and they're not ready to talk, it's not helpful to keep suppressing
right.
them.
It's for every phase of life.
If you've made mistakes with money, you know what that makes you? Over 12.
And now, it's yours. We've purchased a Right Now Media subscription for everyone in our church. So check your inbox for the digital invitation and download the app for instant access to thousands of biblically based videos. Get equipped.
Brilliant, thanks, Kate. Cool, so you can sign up for that in the foyer after the service if you wish. Great, so just going to pray for our offering, and then I believe kids are out today. Got some things for you guys to do, so say a quick prayer. Father, we just thank you for all that you've given us, blessing us with this building and all the things that come with it, Lord. And we just pray over our offering, Lord God. We thank you for those who give generously, and we pray that you would just use it to bless however you see, Father, and to touch your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. So you can give following that. There is a basket up the back if you want to use that. And obviously for those who give via the bank transfer, we really do appreciate it, guys. We are so grateful and bless you all for that. So we'll take a couple of minutes, anyone wants to use that time for the offering. And then after that, we'll dismiss the kids. And Alan's going to come up and preach this morning. So we'll take a minute or two and you can maybe say hello to somebody. Okay, kids, if you're ready to go, you're free to go. Have a nice time. Enjoy yourselves. And for everyone else, we're going to hand over to Alan, and he's going to preach this morning's word.
Brilliant. Well, welcome. There are three priorities, three things that you need to do and prioritize in 2022 to bring the victory that we've been singing about, to bring blessing to other people, to be sure that you get through 2022 with health and blessing and success and hope, because 2022 is coming like a flood. isn't it? There's so much coming at us, so much coming to us, that unless we have these three keys, these three principles, these three priorities in place, we're going to be struggling. We're going to be overwhelmed. But God's been convicting me. God's been moving in me. God's been in working in me to give me confidence to share these with you today. These are three priorities that you will have heard of before, that are not new. They are ancient. But they're the most powerful things to lead us into the spiritual blessings of God, into the kingdom of God, to be everything that God has called us to be. Three things I'm going to talk about this morning. If you're ready, people are just coming back, so it's great to see so many people here. Love to start, love the worship, love the victory call that Tim's put out to us, and God's been stirring that in my heart too, definitely. Loved Stuart's word last week. Stuart, thanks so much. I hope you managed to catch Stuart's word. It was called location, location, location. And if you like, as some people obviously do, good TV programs, location, location, location. I've been thinking and meditating on Stuart's word last week, and encourage you to do that. To think about what we're talking about on a Sunday. Think about it, and one of the scriptures Stuart shared last week was this one up there. It says, "For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God has prepared in advance for us to do." I could take the next year to think about that, and I still wouldn't have got all the truth out of it that is there. So much in it. The Bible is something that you can meditate on for all your life and get something out of it. I've been chewing on it this week to the extent that I've got an even better title than location, location, location. Today's title is Love It or List It, inspired by another TV program by Kirsty Alsop and Phil Spencer. I don't know if you've ever seen Love It or List It. No, Jimmy Dowd, you need to see this. You need to see this. Love It or List It. Same idea as location, location, location. You're looking for a new home. Or the difference this time is the couple, the homeowners, are not sure what to do. Whether to stay or whether to go. Whether to do some work on their home, improve it, or to sell up and buy their dream home. And Kirsty and Phil are there to help them get through that difficult dilemma. Anybody ever in two minds about what to do about something? Ever have a different opinion to your wife or your partner or your spouse as to what to do about important things in life? Yeah. Well, I tell you what. These three things that we're going to see today, if it's like this house, you might be in two minds, but I am telling you, we're going to love these things today. We're not going to list it. Love It or List It. That's the title today. All right. I'm in the Love It team. That is Kirsty's team, and Kirsty looks at the house, understands what the problems are with it, what the couple are unsure about, and inspires them to do some changes, invest some money, make some alterations, invest in it to make it as ideal as they possibly can. Phil is looking at other dream houses that they think they could move into and buy. And at the end of the day, they have to make a decision to love it and stay with the changes, with the investment, or to leave and go and buy up and sell. I'm in Love It team today. We're loving three things today, and I just want to encourage you that this principle is embedded deep within the kingdom of God. Let's look at the next slide, please, Kate. Love it or list it. Jesus said it this way, slightly different approach, but the same idea. Jesus said, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it. How many times have you heard, don't put all your eggs in one basket? How many times have you wanted to just sit on the fence for a little while and see how things go? How often do we find, well, which is the right horse to back? Let's see how things go. It's almost countercultural that there are some things in life that we should give our everything to, that we should back entirely. And that's a slightly nervous proposition. I don't know about you, but I have to look at every shop, every purchase, before I make a decision to buy. Fortunately, I didn't do the same when I was choosing a wife. It was clear to me that I had to give my heart and soul to Sally. There are some things that you need to give your heart and soul to and give up every other alternative. The kingdom of God is like treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field, like pearls of great value. There are three things today that I want to encourage you, that you must love them, you must invest in them, you must improve them, you must not list them. You must give your heart and soul to these three things this year. The problem is, 2022 is going to come like a flood, and there are going to be circumstances, there are going to be situations, there are going to be decisions, there's going to be health, there's going to be finances, there are going to be jobs that are going to come and grab your attention so that you do not make these things a priority. Better tell you what the three things are, eh? Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, here we go. There may be no surprises here. Let's go. Next slide, please, Clara. Three things, and if you like the idea of loving it or listing it, three things you should decide to love in 2023. The first one is your relationship with God. And I'm comparing that to the situation with a couple maybe are not selling their house, because there are people, maybe not in this room, maybe not listening online, but will experience in 2022 a crisis of faith. You will have doubts. You may be sitting here this morning, even come to church, and just unsure about whether God is real. You may not have yet decided that, yes, I believe in the God that we were singing about, the God of victory, the God who is Jesus, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. You may be hesitating to put all your eggs in that one basket. You may have been following and building a relationship with God for many years, but disappointment has come. COVID has come. Isolation has come. You're jaded, you're tired, your faith is weaker than it once was, and it's like in the back burner of your life. It's there, but it's not really there. And you're thinking, maybe this is okay. It's just something that is there and it's good, but you know, it's that. I am encouraging you today. I'm imploring you today to make your relationship with God the most important thing in your life this year, like never before. Like never before, make your relationship with God the priority, put everything you have. Jesus himself said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your might. There is nothing else that you can give your life to, your priority to, your calendar to, your time to, your money to, your energies to, than your relationship with God. I'm imploring you to think, I am going to build that stronger this year. I'm going to come out of 2022 closer to God, more in love with God, more sure of his love for me in 2022. Isn't that a great ambition? Am I going to love it or list it? What are you going to do with your relationship with God in 2022? Second one, your relationship with the Bible. And I say relationship deliberately. The Bible is the most incredible gift to us, the most remarkable collection of books from ancient times that we have. It is the wellspring of all wisdom. Everything that you need for salvation, everything that we can have that will help us in our relationship with God is contained in this incredible, complex, sometimes difficult collection of stories. You need to spend time with it. It can be read incorrectly. I've been encouraged and challenged this year that some of the ways I've read the Bible in the past are not as useful as effective as they could be. Just dipping in and out and looking at the first scripture can be helpful, but actually you really need to understand in depth, in context. You need to understand more about what it is. And sometimes, you know, I know many people that have written off the Old Testament, for example, because it's full of seemingly our wrathful God. But did you know, Jesus, every decision, the purpose of his life, the goal of his life, his encouragement to do all that he did came from the Old Testament. Jesus' life fulfilled everything that was promised in him. And so it's an incredible foundation for us as Christians to understand what it means to be a Christian. So I would encourage you, if you've in the past written off the Old Testament or find it difficult, think again, that right move stuff. Get some instruction. Sit down with people in your life group. Help find some study guides. TheBibleProject.com is an amazing website and app now that you can use to help you understand the Bible. Spend time in it. Spend energy with it. Talk about it. Ask God, how can I understand the Bible? And you will find wisdom that will help you in your life, in your work, in your finances, in your family. It is a wellspring of life and health and wisdom. I encourage you not to think of the Bible just as a moral handbook, although it gives us moral guidance. It is much, much more than that. And I quote TheBibleProject.com, a unified story that leads to Jesus. Everything about the Bible leads us to Jesus. When you're reading the Bible, what does it tell you about Jesus? There's incredible depth around there. And I encourage you to make your relationship with the Bible a high priority this year, a daily thing that you look at, something that you study in depth, that you bring along to, that you spend energy and effort in to glean more out of it. And you will not be disappointed. You will grow in wisdom and understanding and the knowledge of God's love for you. Third one, your relationship with church. Well, you're all here, which is great. You're all listening. That's tremendous. So I'm preaching to the converted to an extent. But I know coming out of COVID, this is a particular challenge and thing to think about, that church is going to happen in a new way post-COVID. Online is something that will remain. And it's a great thing, I believe, that God will use all things to work together for the good of those who love him. But I want to encourage you, I feel encouraged to press on you the importance of what the church is. Biblically and spiritually, the church isn't just this gathering of people, it's the Bible describes it as the body of Christ. If we are prioritizing our relationship with God, if we are reading and meditating, understanding what the Bible is encouraging us to do, we will come to church and make it the highest priority, one of the highest priorities in our life, because that's where we learn how to make sense of the Bible with each other. That's where we learn to love one another, to care for one another, to encourage one another, to worship the living God together. The worst thing about COVID, which is terribly superficial for me, was having to watch Match of the Day with no crowd. I mean, it was just dire, honestly. I mean, gosh, sorry. That's hardly a hardship, is it? You can't have a good football match without a crowd. To be honest, church is great, but you know, even if it's a small group gathering, worship and praising together is the joy of my life, and it is just the most beautiful thing that we can do, that as we gather together and worship together. I would encourage you. I had a great text, the host team, Craig and Ian and Paul this morning, all there before me, setting up. I texted them last night, just already got within minutes responses back. Ian Scott, I loved his message back. He says, I was just checking, you're on host tomorrow, is that okay, are you available? Ian says, it's in my diary and set in stone. There was not a... There is no chance Ian was not going to be here this morning. No chance. Ian, thank you for that. But for me, that's the word of God to me and to you this morning. What are you putting in your calendar so far in 2022? Holidays? Yep, that's great, of course. Maybe. Can you? Well, it's difficult. What are you doing on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday this week? Do you fill it up your diary, commitments, arrangements, meetings? I tell you what, put in your diary right now every single church service that you can come to, get along to. Put in your diary, set it in stone. Because everything that comes against you to not come gives you an indication that perhaps this is important, perhaps there's a spiritual thing going on, perhaps there's a battle going on. And we all can't come to every meeting, that's not what I'm saying, but put a priority in it. We put an absolute priority in meeting and gathering together this year. This is as Stuart loved it, the location, 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 in time and space. This year, this is, I believe, one of the biggest priorities for us as a church and across the world, that if we can... Those who can, come. Please come. Those who can't, come online and join us there, because there's power in that too. Come to church. Your relationship with church is one of the most important things that you have. Put your time, your energy, and resources in it. And we want to make it as attractive and as exciting as possible for our kids, for our friends, for our families. We need to get behind this mission. I would encourage you that the service will start at 10 o'clock on a Sunday morning, typically. There were times in the past when we didn't manage to start on time. We are now, because we're worshiping live. It would be great if everybody was here before then, ready to go. Ready to go. And I tell you what, I know it's a massive battle for people with kids, for people with jobs, for people. I know it's hard, but put it in your diary, set it in stone. That investment, that commitment will bring dividends and reap benefits. And you know what it does? It encourages everyone else. Hebrews 12:30 says, do not give up meeting together as some are tending to do. And it's all about the power of worship and coming together in worship. So as we come together in worship, we will encourage one another. I just love seeing people worship. There's just nothing like it, to be encouraged, to be led into the presence of God, to declare the presence of God, declare the truths that we're singing about. Make that relationship with church a high commitment. I'm just leading into the last one. Maybe the band can come back up just now, and Tim, you can maybe help me on keys here. You know, it was Epiphany this week, the festival of the Epiphany, when the three kings come back. Kate, can you just put the last slide on? There you go. Thank you, Kate. I didn't really know what the festival of Epiphany was. Michael, did you know what the festival of Epiphany was? Yeah, on the 6th of January, the 12 days of Christmas, from 25th of January to the 6th. The church for hundreds of years, in the West particularly, has been celebrating the festival of Epiphany. Markle, you'll know all about this, I'm sure. The festival of Epiphany, celebrating the fact that it was the three kings who, if we read the story of Matthew closely, we'll realize came after the actual initial birth, not the same time as the shepherds, representing the miracle and the revelation that Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, didn't come just for the people of Israel, the Jews. He came for all men everywhere, the Gentiles. And the church decided to celebrate that as an Epiphany festival on the 6th of January. Isn't that brilliant? The three kings coming, representing you and I, coming to Jesus as a gift of worship. Great thing. Did not know that before. That's significant for me because I want to think about these priorities, these commitments that I'm encouraging you to make. Are like gifts that you give to God and to each other. They brought gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and scholars understand that the gold represented the fact that Jesus was king, that God was king. And I want to ask you to put your heart and soul, your mind, everything about you into this truth, into this relationship with God, that, and ask him to be your king. Invite Jesus to be your king this year. Not just now, tomorrow, the next day, every single other day. When the world is coming at you, if you have that in place, if you have this pillar in place, this conviction in place, this priority in place that God is my king, whatever happens. It's like an act of worship. It's an act of encouragement for everybody else. The frankincense, we understand, represents the priest, that Jesus was a priest, that worship, and then coming together to worship is an act of praise and worship. Committing to church, loving church, getting involved with other people, putting it in your diary is an act of worship. Myrrh is for sacrifice, that Jesus would one day die and rise again. And there is in all these things, in all these commitments, in all this effort to transform this part of your life, there is some sacrifice. You have to not do some other things so that you can do these things. You have to stand up to, sometimes things will come up sickness, health issues that are significant, and I'm not talking about those, but sometimes there's just difficulties, obstacles that come in the way of these three things in particularly, and you need to know these are a spiritual battle that come against you. There is a force of evil, the devil, who will want you to make these things, he will want you to list these things, he will want you to say give up on your faith, give up on God, certainly give up on the church. Don't you dare bother reading that stupid Bible. But I tell you what, these are the most precious, the most beautiful, the most powerful priorities and commitments that are gifts to us as well. Ephesians 2, 8 and 10 says, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast." This is following on from last week's word and where I want you to take it this week. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. That's my verse for the year. I would encourage you to ask God, what's my verse for the year? For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. Let's stand together, can we please? Just as we finish, I want to encourage you with these words. I'm going to read this. I'm going to try and read this every day. And believe, I'm going to speak to my spirit. And I'm encouraging you to do something similar, to reinforce that this is all grace. Your relationship with God is a gift that God has given you. You've had a present. The Bible is a gift to us from God, and we are a gift to each other. I want you to unwrap these gifts this year. I want you to make the most of them. I want you to prioritize them. Don't put them on the back burner. It's not about works, so we can't boast, but here's this truth, and I just want to ask you to pray with me now. If you can, lift up hands. And I encourage you to say this: I am God's handiwork. You can think it, you can whisper it, you can say it, you can, and if you are struggling to say it, I understand. It is nothing that we have earned, because it's by grace. But this is who you are. You are God's handiwork, creating Christ Jesus to do good works. Oh, Lord Jesus, I pray right now by the power of your Holy Spirit that this revelation would come for each one of us, this epiphany, this amazing sense of something beautiful and true. It is a gift that God gives you, that your relationship with God is the most important thing in your life. That you can trust it. You can put your heart and your soul and your time and your energy into believing in the God of creation, in the God that you find through Jesus Christ, because you are his handiwork, creating Christ Jesus to do good works. Father, I thank you, and I pray right now for every single person here, that you would start to bring revelation of the things that you've prepared them for. You've created them for this year. Specific tasks. Encouraging each other. Loving one another. Caring for your family. Working. All these things that seem mundane, but I believe are good works prepared in advance for us to do. You have purpose. You have identity. You have love in Jesus Christ, our Lord. I pray that that revelation would inspire you. You know that you are important, that you have things that you need to do for God, that he has called you, he has prepared you. Using the trials and everything that has come to your life to this moment, to this day, God will use for good for those who love him. nothing will be lost. Everything will be able to be used by God. Lord, I thank you for this truth. I thank you for this truth that we are God's handiwork. We have good works to do. And if we set our stall out to prioritize a relationship with you, a relationship with the Bible and a relationship with the church, you will bring fruitfulness, you will bring healing, you will bring health, not just to us, because this is not how it, we are limited, but we're going to see us bringing blessing to those around us. We're going to see blessing to those closest to us. We're going to see favor on those in our neighborhood, in our community. Imagine if every one of us is filled with this knowledge and truth that we are God's handiwork prepared in Christ Jesus to do good works. I pray that on you. I ask that you would receive it in the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Thanks, guys. Thank you. I ask you in this moment, maybe could we do that first song again? Can we do that one again? Because that is just a great opportunity to release your worship, to release your gifting, to release this anointing in the name of Jesus. God bless you. Amen.
To every soul held captive by depression,
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind, 'cause I know there is peace within His presence. I speak Jesus.
Song, is that not amazing? That is incredible. Thank you to these guys for blessing us. I encourage you to play that song all week in your homes and sing it over yourselves and your situations and all those around you. And what an amazing morning, Alan. That was a word from heaven. I honestly loved every second of you speaking this morning. That was tremendous. Really, really solid, good New Year word. That's probably one of the best I've heard, Alan. Thank you so much. So much to apply. Loving our church, our God. So good, Alan. Thank you so much. So much goes into it. And I know Alan's heart is for each one of us to be blessed by God's word. So we're really grateful and blessed, Alan. Thank you for all the effort. Sally, you've probably sacrificed some time with Alan while I prepared that. So bless you as well. It's been amazing. I'm really excited for this year, and a word like that really kicks it off and stirs you, doesn't it? It gets you moving. And when I meet with you guys, like Alan said, it just stirs me. See, when I see Derek Cook lift his hands in worship, that man is an inspiration. And I watched him at the Christmas Eve. I'm always up the front, but I got to stand behind him one night, and it just blessed me so much to see Derek. He couldn't stretch his hands any further. Sold out for Jesus. I love being around people like you, Derek, and everybody else in here. We're a family. We encourage each other and strengthen each other. And let's just keep going, guys. Let's keep moving. Keep blessing one another. Thank you to everyone who made this morning happen. The guys up the back, we really thank you guys for the work and effort. Colleen, guys on the doors, like sound like bouncers, you know, the hosts. Aaron puts so much into it. These guys. Everyone does so well. Let's just give everyone a round of applause and bless Jesus. Have an amazing week, guys. I'm sure these guys will send us out on a high yet again. And we will see you, bless you all, and have an incredible week. We'll see you here next Sunday, Tuesday night prayer meeting. If you've got prayer requests, send them in, and we'll fight our battles together. In Jesus' name, let's go for it. Maybe that song a wee bit more, because it's so good.
Your name is